Welcome, everybody, to this section on aircraft performance. My name is Jeff Taylor, and I'm going to be guiding you through our discussion of aircraft performance. But before I begin, I want to just give a little bit of a background about how aircraft performance fits in the larger aeronautics framework. Wow. Okay, so aeronautics, when we say aeronautics, what we're referring to is the study of how a vehicle moves through the atmosphere. Okay, so there's going to be two main parts that make up aeronautics. And the first is something that you should be familiar with, and that's aerodynamics. And the second part is called flight mechanics. Okay, now aerodynamics, just as a review, is the study of the forces that arise on a body as it moves through a fluid. And so, for our purposes, we're gonna talk about an airplane. So here's an airplane for you, and we're gonna talk about the forces that arise on this airplane as it moves through the air. And the main forces are the lift and the drag. Okay, so you should be familiar with these things. Flight mechanics, on the other hand, is the study of how the forces on a body or on an aircraft in particular, how those forces affect the motion of the aircraft. Okay, so you can quickly see that if you really want to understand how a vehicle moves through the atmosphere, you've got to have analysis of you have to have a coupled analysis that incorporates both aerodynamics and flight mechanics. Okay, now flight mechanics itself can be thought of in terms of three main divisions, and these three divisions are known. The first one is known as aircraft performance, and that's of course what we're talking about in this section. So aircraft performance. The other two are stability and control, and simulation. Okay, and stability and control and simulation, these two are going to be the topics of other courses. In this course, we will focus on aircraft performance. Okay, so when I talk about aircraft performance, what do I mean? Well, let's consider a little red airplane. I'm gonna see if I can draw it here. Okay, a little red airplane flying through the air. Aircraft performance. When I say it means the study of the performance, of course, of this aircraft as it moves through different flight phases. So those phases in this course are going to include takeoff, climb, cruise, maneuver, descent, and then landing. Okay, so let me label these real quick. We have takeoff here, climb, cruise, maneuver, and in this course we'll mostly focus on turns, descent, and landing. Okay, and so some of the questions that we want to answer with our analysis are these are just examples. So for example, you might say, how fast does the aircraft fly? Or how fast can it fly? Or how fast can it climb? You might have to ask, how big of a runway do we have to use in order to take off or land? We might ask, how far can the aircraft fly? What's its range? Or that's wow. Or how efficiently does the aircraft operate? Or we might ask, how high can the aircraft fly? These are all questions that we might answer with performance analysis. And in this course, we will answer these questions and a few more to some degree. And there's many, many more questions that you could ask. Aircraft performance is a large field, and there's a lot you can do with it. So just quickly before we finish, I just want to give a little bit of a context as to how aircraft design and performance analysis fit together. So I'm going to attempt to draw a top-down view of an airplane here. See about the wings. Okay. So here's an airplane. On the design side, there's a lot of questions we have to answer and a lot of decisions we have to make. So for example, we might need to decide how big the wing should be. We need to decide what shape the wing should be, if they're swept back or straight. We need to decide the shape of the fuselage. We need to decide the center of gravity of the aircraft. We need to look at the size of the vertical stabilizer and the horizontal stabilizers. There's a whole lot of questions that we have to answer. Now, on the performance side, we're mostly concerned with how the design affects how the aircraft flies. And it does affect how the aircraft flies. So this is to represent performance analysis. Okay, so you can quickly you can really imagine that the size of the wings or the weight of the aircraft are going to affect how it performs, right? So there's a clear connection here between the design and the performance. But on the other hand, when we look at a performance, we realize that in a lot of cases, an aircraft is designed to fulfill a specific mission. And that specific mission, in most cases, has some sort of performance requirement or performance constraint. So for example, you may have to fly a certain range, or you may have to be able to fly at a certain altitude, or you may have maneuverability requirements, for example, for an acrobatic plane or a military plane. There's a whole lot of other things that it could be, right? There's just a whole bunch. And usually these requirements are what drive the design. Okay, so the design affects the performance. And because of that, the performance requirements drive the design. So it's really this coupled process. So when you're designing an aircraft, it's very important that you understand the performance of the aircraft and how the design affects the performance and vice versa. So we'll see a little bit about how this works a little bit more later on in the course.